hope that all is well and that you can hear. Just me this morning, sorry, a little late. That's how I normally introduce myself. Good morning, I'm Paul, and I'm sorry I'm a little late. Just back from holiday, so even more confused than normal. So we're going to be doing morning prayer from Common Worship. The link is in the notes telling you where to find that if you want to follow along. We remember today Alphage, Archbishop of Canterbury, who was martyred in 1012. Our readings today are going to be Psalm 96, and then I'm going to be reading from Ephesians 1. But it's great to be with you this morning, on this rather beautiful morning. So, let's come to prayer. This remarkable weekend for us as a nation. Many will have been touched by the scenes from Windsor at the weekend. Many that are grieving would be able to relate to some of the things that were being felt, even for those in the royal household. But we come to a bright new dawn this week. So, O Lord, open our lips, and our mouth shall proclaim your praise. In your resurrection, O Christ, let heaven and earth rejoice. Alleluia. Blessed are you, Lord God, of our salvation. To you be praise and glory forever. As once you ransomed your people from Egypt and led them to freedom in the promised land, so now you have delivered us from the dominion of darkness and brought us into the kingdom of your risen Son. May we, the first fruits of your new creation, rejoice in this new day you have made, and praise you for your mighty acts. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Blessed be God forever. The night has passed and the day lies open before us, so let us pray with one heart and mind, as we rejoice in the gift of this new day. So may the light of your presence, O God, set our hearts on fire with love for you, now and forever. Amen. So we come to Psalm 96. Sing to the Lord a new song. Sing to the Lord, all the earth. Sing to the Lord and bless his name. Tell out his salvation from day to day. Declare his glory among the nations, his wonders among all peoples. For great is the Lord and greatly to be praised. He is more to be feared than all gods. For all the gods of the nations are but idols. It is the Lord who made the heavens. Honour and majesty are before him. Power and splendour are in his sanctuary. Ascribe to the Lord, you families of the peoples. Ascribe to the Lord honour and strength. Ascribe to the Lord the honour due to his name. Bring offerings and come into his courts. O worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness. Let the whole earth tremble before him. Tell it out among the nations that the Lord is king. He has made the world so firm that it cannot be moved. He will judge the peoples with equity. Let the heavens rejoice, and let the earth be glad. Let the sea thunder and all that is in it. Let the fields be joyful and all that is in them. Let all the trees of the wood shout for joy before the Lord. For he comes to judge the earth with righteousness. He will judge the world and the peoples with his truth. Glory to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now and shall be forever. Amen. If you want to read the Old Testament reading, it's Deuteronomy 5, 1 to 22, and the start of the Ten Commandments. We're going to read from Ephesians chapter 1, verses 1 to 14. Paul, an apostle of Christ Jesus by the will of God, to the saints who are in Ephesus and are faithful in Christ Jesus. Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us in Christ with every spiritual blessing in the heavenly places, just as he chose us in Christ before the foundation of the world to be holy and blameless before him in love. He destined us for adoption as his children through Jesus Christ, according to the good pleasure of his will, to the praise of his glorious grace he has, and that he freely bestowed on us. It is in the Beloved. In him we have redemption through his blood, the forgiveness of our trespasses, according to the riches of his grace that he lavished on us. With all wisdom and insight, he has made known to us the mystery of his will, according to his good pleasure that he set forth in Christ, as a plan for the fullness of time, to gather up all things in him, things in heaven and things on earth. In Christ we have also obtained an inheritance, having been destined according to the purpose of him who accomplishes all things according to his counsel and will, so that we, who are the first to set our hope on Christ, might live for the praise of his glory. In him you also, when you heard the word of truth, the gospel of your salvation, and had believed in him, were marked with the seal of the promised Holy Spirit. This is the pledge of our inheritance toward adoption as God's own people, to the praise of his glory. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Seal of his Holy Spirit upon us, that mark of our discipleship in him. O death is swallowed up in victory. Where, O death, is your sting? Christ is risen from the dead, the first fruits of those who have fallen asleep. Death is swallowed up in victory. The trumpet will sound and the dead shall be raised. Where, O death, is your sting? We shall not all sleep, but we shall be changed. Death is swallowed up in victory. Where, O death, is your sting? Blessed are those who are persecuted for the cause of right, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Alleluia. Blessed be the Lord, the God of Israel, who has come to his people and set them free. He has raised up for us a mighty Saviour, born of the house of his servant David. Through his holy prophets, God promised of old to save us from our enemies, from the hands of all that hate us, to show mercy to our ancestors, and to remember his holy covenant. This was the oath God swore to our father Abraham, to set us free from the hands of our enemies, free to worship him without fear, holy and righteous in his sight all the days of our life. And you, child, shall be called the prophet of the Most High, for you will go before the Lord to prepare his way, to give his people knowledge of salvation by the forgiveness of all their sins. In the tender compassion of our God, the dawn from on high shall break upon us, to shine on those who dwell in darkness and the shadow of death, and to guide our feet into the way of peace. O glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. Blessed are those who are persecuted for the cause of right, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Alleluia. We come to our intercessions this morning as we pray for the needs of the world, our own needs. Lord, we acknowledge you, your presence with us. Lord, we thank you for your glory as we look at the beauty of this day. Lord, help us to know your goodness, to know your power and might, to know your majesty and creativity. Oh Lord, thank you for who you are. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Lord, we thank you for your people throughout this earth which we set, for all who worship you, who seek to follow your lead, your call. Lord, may you release us into all that you have for us. Release your church into what you have for it in these days to come, this time to come. We pray for your church not only here in Redditch, but we pray for your church across our diocese, thinking today of St Mark in Pensnet. Lord, we pray for them as they seek to work together with a humble heart, to help each other and to encourage each other and to remember the community is the church we serve. Pray for Vanessa Tobin there. Lord, we pray for them in that part of our diocese. We think further afield for the diocese of Boga in the Democratic Republic of the Congo, Bishop Mugenyi William Bahamuka. We pray for him. We pray for that diocese set in that challenging part of Africa. Lord, as they wake with different challenges to us this day, Lord, may you provide for them in all their needs. Our Lord, in your mercy. Lord, we pray for our nation as we've come out of the week of mourning for His Royal Highness Prince Philip. Continue to pray for the royal family as they come to terms with their loss, praying particularly for Her Majesty the Queen. And we think of all who are mourning in this time where funeral services are not what you would desire or want, where we lack some of the interactions that naturally would occur that ease the challenges of these times of transition. So Lord, be with all those who mourn this day. Our Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And Lord, as we so conscious of spring breaking forth, Lord, help us to, in this Easter season, see those signs of new hope, of resurrection. Lord, we pray that for us in all sorts of different aspects of our shared life. As we see nature bursting forth, Lord, may we see our commerce and industry recover. May we see society renewed and refreshed in new and creative ways. Where there have been real challenges during this time with isolation, even oppression, Lord, we pray for more freedom. So Lord, be with us as we seek to move into from spring into summer, into fruitfulness. Our Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord, we lift ourselves to you that we may know your goodness this day. Where there is need for healing, Lord, may you bring that. We pray for healing for those known to us who suffer in body, mind or spirit. Minded of my colleague Garth, who's following his injury the other weekend. Lord, we pray for swift recovery of all who are in a hospital or recovering at home from accident, injury or sickness. Our Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And Lord, as things open up across our nation, as other challenges are still with us, we pray for peace throughout our nation. Here, close to home, but also just across the Irish Sea in Northern Ireland. In all places, may you bring your peace. So merciful God, who raised up your servant half-aged to be a pastor to your people, gave him grace to suffer for justice and true religion, grant that we who celebrate his martyrdom may know the power of the risen Christ in our hearts and share his peace in lives offered to your service. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. And so, rejoicing in God's new creation, as our Saviour taught us, so we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. May the risen Christ grant us the joys of eternal life. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Alleluia. Alleluia. Thanks be to God. Alleluia. Alleluia. Thank you for joining me this morning or at some other point during the day. Continue with our prayers during the week. You'll be aware, I'm hoping that Alpha starts this week, and we're praying that people will be able to be blessed by that. So if you know someone that you'd think about inviting along, send them along to Holy Trinity. redditch.org.uk/courses, and they can sign up through that webpage or contact us by any other means that you can find. Do encourage people to be part of that. It's just a really great way of finding out what faith in Christ is about. I hope and pray that you all have really great days and look forward to seeing you more during the week.